Welcome to Exams Daily YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to see the daily current affairs of June 8, 2019. Before that, those who didn't subscribe our Exams Daily YouTube channel, click the subscribe button and also do not forget to click the bell button to get updates from our YouTube channel. June 8, World Oceans Day. This World Oceans Day is being observed on 8th June every year. And the concept of this day, that is the World Oceans Day, was originally proposed in 1992 by Canada's International Centre for Ocean Development and the Ocean Institute of Canada at the Earth Summit, UN Conference on Environment and Development in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. So this Earth Summit was held in 1992, and in that summit, this Canada's International Centre for Ocean Development and the Ocean Institute of Canada proposed this World Oceans Day concept. And the purpose of this day is to inform the public of the impact of human actions on the oceans and to develop a worldwide movement of citizens for the ocean, and also to mobilize and to unite the world's population on a project for the sustainable management of the world's oceans. And the focus for this day in 2019 is gender and the ocean. So here we can expect the question that the World Oceans Day is observed on which date? It is observed on June 8. June 8, World Brain Tumor Day. This World Brain Tumor Day is being observed on June 8 every year, and this day was set aside to be celebrated globally by an association of brain tumor that is based in Germany. And this World Brain Tumor Day helps in raising awareness to the public and educating them on brain tumor, a type of cancer that is not common and most people do not know about this cancer. And this day also helps the people who are suffering from brain tumor in facing their challenges. So this brain tumor, it is a condition that occurs when the cells in the brain multiply in an abnormal way or a way that cannot be controlled. So the growth of the cells cannot be controlled. So it will multiply in an abnormal way. So that is this brain tumor. The tumor can be malignant, meaning it is cancerous, or it can be non-cancerous, benign. The tumors are grade are from grade 1 to 4, and this depends with their location, how fast the cells are multiplying and the spread to adjacent areas or organs. So here we can expect the question that this World Brain Tumor Day is observed on which date? It is observed on June 8. Exhibition, Unknown Masterpieces of Himachal Folk Art. Exhibition named Unknown Masterpieces of Himachal Folk Art was inaugurated at National Museum in New Delhi by the Culture Minister Prahlad Singh Patel. And this exhibition is being jointly organized by the National Museum in New Delhi and the Home of Folk Art Gurugram. And in this exhibition, more than 240 artifacts will be on display. And the aim of this exhibition is to highlight the folk art tradition of the Himachal Pradesh. So to highlight the folk art tradition of the Himachal Pradesh, this exhibition was inaugurated at National Museum in New Delhi. The name of the exhibition is Unknown Masterpieces of Himachal Folk Art. So this National Museum, it was inaugurated on August 15, 1949 in the Rashtrapati Bhavan by Shri R.C. Rajagopalachari, the Governor General of India. And the foundation of this present building was led by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the Prime Minister of India, on May 12, 1955. So here we can expect the question that this Unknown Masterpieces of Himachal Folk Art exhibition was inaugurated in which place? It is inaugurated. It was inaugurated in New Delhi, and it was inaugurated by the Culture Minister Prahlad Singh Patel, and the National Museum is in New Delhi. Yakshagana episodes to debut in Marathi soon. A team of Yakshagana enthusiasts, that is the team of Yakshagana traditional art form from Pune, have been attempting to write and perform this Yakshagana episodes in Marathi. And this Yakshagana is an energetic and attractive art form of Karnataka. So the team of this art form, that is Yakshagana from Pune, have been attempting to write and perform this episodes in Marathi language. This Yakshagana is a traditional theatre form developed in Udupi in the state of Karnataka, and this art combines dance, music, dialogue, costume, makeup and stage techniques with a unique style and form. And this art is believed to have evolved from pre-classical music and theatre during the period of Bhakti movement. And this Yakshagana is strongly influenced by the Vaishnava Bhakti movement. So here we can expect the question that Yakshagana is a traditional theatre form of which state? It is a theatre form of Karnataka. Studying Olive Ridley's in Odisha. To study the mass nesting of olive ridleys and the environmental factors related to this turtle, a proposal has been made to establish a permanent research center near the Rishikulya Roorkee on the Odisha coast. And this research center is to study the mass nesting of the olive ridleys. And this research center is expected to be established at a cost of more than 9 crore. And the forest department is planning to have it in the Kalikote forest range, which is near this Rishikulya Roorkee. So this permanent research center to come up in Kalikote forest range, which is near this Rishikulya Roorkee, which is the place of the mass nesting of this olive ridley turtles. And the center would be involved in the detailed study of the habits and the habitat of the turtles and the coastal flora and fauna. This olive ridley sea turtle, also known as the Pacific ridley sea turtle, or the second smallest and the most abundant of all sea turtles found in the world. And this species of sea turtle is found in warm and tropical waters, primarily in the Pacific and Indian Oceans. And they can also be found in the warm waters of the Atlantic Ocean too. So the IUCN status of this olive ridley is vulnerable. So here we can expect the question that a permanent research center to study the mass nesting of the olive ridleys to be established in which state? It is to be established in Odisha. UK Foreign Office board gets first Indian origin member. Kumar Iyer has been appointed by the United Kingdom government as the chief economist of the Foreign and Commonwealth Office, that is FCO. This makes him the first Indian origin members of the department's management board. So he is the first Indian origin member to hold this post, and he has been appointed as the UK government by the UK government as the chief economist of the Foreign and Commonwealth Office, FCO. So here we can expect the question that who has been appointed by the UK government as the chief economist of the Foreign and Commonwealth Office? It is Indian origin Kumar Iyer. Russia prepared to drop nuclear weapons agreement treaty with US. The Russian President Vladimir Putin has said that Russia was prepared to drop a nuclear weapons agreement treaty with the US. And he also said that Washington showed no genuine interest in conducting talks on extending this New START treaty, which caps the number of nuclear warheads well below Cold War limit. So for this reason, the Russian president has said that Russia was prepared to drop this nuclear weapons agreement treaty with the US. And this treaty, that is New START, Strategic Arms Reduction Treaty, is a nuclear arms reduction treaty between the United States and the Russian Federation with the formal name of Measures for the Further Reduction and Limitation of the Strategic Offensive Arm. So this treaty was signed by the US President Barack Obama and Russian counterpart Dmitry Medvedev in Prague in 2010, and this treaty expires in 2021. And this New START treaty replaced the Treaty of Moscow, which was due to expire in December 2012. So now Russian president has said that Washington showed no genuine interest in conducting talks on the extending of this treaty. So for this reason, he said that Russia was prepared to drop this treaty with the US. So here we can expect the question that which country prepared to drop nuclear weapons agreement treaty with US? That is Russia. Ira the Robo. This Ira is a robo and is the brainchild of Aidan Meller. And he says that Ida is the world's first ultra-realistic humanoid artist. So this Ida is created as the humanoid artist, and this Ida is able to draw creatively by using the artificial intelligence technology. So this humanoid robo uses artificial intelligence to make images that have been sold for over 1 million pounds. So the Ida is a robot, is a brainchild of Aidan Meller, and is created as a humanoid artist. So here we can expect the question that what is this Ida recently seen in news? That is a robot and is created as a humanoid artist. China gives green light for local 5G rollout amid tensions with US. China gave its major state-owned companies the green light to start rolling out the 5G services in its effort to move ahead in the global race for setting up the super-fast telecommunication system amid simmering tensions with the US over technology and trade. So amid tension with US, China gave its nod to the rolling out of 5G services in the country. And this 5G is the next generation cellular technology with download speed started to be 10 to 100 times faster than the current 4G LTE networks. So for this, China gave its green light to the companies. So here we can expect the question that which country gives green light for local 5G rollout amid tensions with US? That is China. G20 Ministerial Meeting on Trade and Digital Economy. The Union Minister of Commerce and Industry and Railways, Piyush Goyal, is leading the Indian delegation for the G20 Ministerial Meeting on Trade and Digital Economy. And this meeting is being held on 8th to 9th June 2019 in Tsukuba City, Ibaraki Prefecture, Japan. So this G20 Ministerial Meeting on Trade and Digital Economy is being held in the Japan from on 8th to 9th June 2019. And the Union Minister of Commerce and Industry and Railways, Piyush Goyal, is leading the Indian delegation for this meeting. And the Indian Commerce Minister will discuss the development in the global trade situation, WTO matters and digital trade in this meeting. And he will also hold dialogue with other participating trade ministers on current international trade and investment. And in this meeting, for the first time, the ministers of Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology is going to attend this meeting, is going to participate in this session. So this is the first time the ministers from this Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology is participating in this digital economy meeting. So here we can expect the question that G20 Ministerial Meeting on Trade and Digital Economy was held in which country? It was held in Japan. Asim Premji will retire as Executive Chairman of Wipro in July. The IT industry icon Asim Premji will retire as the Executive Chairman of Wipro with effect from 30th July this year. So after him, his son Rishad Premji will take over as the Executive Chairman of the Wipro. And this Asim Premji led this company for 53 years. And the board also announced that the Chief Executive and Executive Director, Abid Ali S. Nimchuwala, will be redesignated as CEO and Managing Director of the Wipro. So Asim Premji will retire as the Executive Chairman of the Wipro, and the next Executive Chairman will be his son Rishad Premji. So here we can expect the question that who has been appointed as the Executive Chairman of Wipro, and the Chairman is Rishad Premji after the Asim Premji's retirement. Vishwanath Anand loses to Magnus Carlsen in Armageddon. Vishwanath Anand suffered defeat against world champion Magnus Carlsen of Norway in the Armageddon game at the Altibox Norway Chess Tournament. So in the Altibox Norway Chess Tournament and in that Armageddon game, Vishwanath Anand loses to Magnus Carlsen. So here we can expect the question that Armageddon game is related to which sport? It is related to chess tournament. In the description box below this video, we have given the current affairs English, Tamil and Hindi PDF link. We hope this video will be useful. Do comment, like, share and subscribe our Exams Daily YouTube channel. Thank you.